In the mid-1990s, it was still hard to get people to understand what solar design was all about. There was some consciousness about the greenhouse effect and growing concern. And in this episode of Your Place or Mine, it highlights the benefits and the approach to solar design and how it can solve or start to solve the world problems as we saw it at the time.
Well, this is the life. With a lovely home overlooking the Port Mandurah canals and even a launch tied up at the front ready to go for a cruise, I could really get used to this. Designed by architect Gary Baverstock and built by its retired owners, this home has 25 metres of river frontage, all facing due west, with superb views up and down the canal. Before building this home, its owners decided to make maximum use of solar principles for lighting and temperature control, but its westerly aspect into the afternoon sun posed a real problem for the designer. Well, here's the architect now. Hi, Gary.
Hi, Anne.
Well, this is a lovely big room to walk into to start with.
Yes, it's a main room in the house, Anne, and the owners are able to sit there and look at the view, and we had to get some winter sun into this room,
so
obviously.
This is where you put that solar design theory into practice.
That's correct.
And how does it work?
Well, this skylight is a main feature of that. And in the winter time, we're able to get the winter sun to come through and it penetrates right into the room. The owners can sit there in the sun and look at the view at the same time.
So those slats are angled like that just to create that effect?
That's correct, Anne. They're there to allow the winter sun to come through. We're orientated to the north, but we had privacy problems, and that allows the winter sun to come through and yet shade in the summertime.
By creating a large open space inside the house with step-down levels, Gary was able to take advantage of the sloping block. Then clever placement of corner windows made the most of canal views while still keeping that privacy to the north. The use of lots of glass along the northern and western sides was also a real problem for sun control.
Shade control is achieved by large solar pergolas that flow from the north round to the west, and they allow the winter sun to come through but then shade the windows on the west side, which are kept off the floor as much as possible, so we could get the view without having too big an area of glass.
Good lines of sight through the home make it feel bigger than it really is. The main entry foyer is very impressive, and its feature is definitely this freestanding staircase, which is made of Nayata wood. Along with this beautifully moulded curve, the steps and balustrading have been left open and floating to let in as much light as possible. Upstairs, two bedrooms and a bathroom have all been cleverly designed to retain those impressive views across the canal. Even the master bedroom downstairs has a canal view. Despite the difficulties, owners Don and Shirley are very pleased with their solar design home.
Definitely, that is the reason that we spent so much time on the house, because we don't like artificial lighting and artificial heating, and we also wanted something to so we could see and still be cool.
And so it really does suit the lifestyle then, Don, in that respect.
Very much indeed, yes. Couldn't be better.
I would say within the next 5 years, we're going to see a lot more solar design houses right through the state. Let's face it, we simply have to do that. As a society, we have to save energy. We have to reduce pollution. It not only makes sense for the owners to live in a comfortable, bright house, but also do something for the community and the planet.